अब रितेश के लिए मैं क्या कहूँ, बहुत कम लोग ऐसे हैं जो कि साइंस और पर्सनल लाइफ को मर्ज कर देते हैं, तो रितेश इज़ वन ऑफ देम। आई थिंक फ्रॉम मॉर्निंग टू नाइट ही जस्ट थिंक्स अबाउट वॉट ही कैन डू फॉर जियोलॉजी, फॉर साइंस, इन बिटवीन लिविंग अ नॉर्मल लाइफ। सो लॉट ऑफ पीपल हैव डिवाइडेड देयर लाइव्स इनटू वेरियस कंपार्टमेंट्स, बट आई थिंक द बिगेस्ट फीचर इन रितेश आर्यज लाइफ इज द फैक्ट दैट देयर इज नो पार्टीशन। देयर इज नो पार्टीशन।
सर आप ऐसी ऐसी बातें बोल देते हो ना कि
That's true. It's true that you can talk about groundwater and next day or next moment you can talk about Gyani ka Dhaba. There are not many people who have merged the scientific parts of their life into their lives as a whole. You know, so that's a very big, it's a very big achievement, and at least for me, that is one of your very essential points. You know, the fact that you can think of a mineral water plant along with a museum and parking for your drilling vehicles at the same time is, in my opinion, is a really great thing, great quality, and that is something that I appreciate. You know, also you are always willing, always eager to display what you've got and share your knowledge. There are not many people who like to share what they have done or their concepts with other people. So
what do you feel about this, the concept of this museum?
It's very good. I love the architecture and the fact that you have yourself conceived the whole idea, and I know that you've collected fossils for the last maybe 20-30 years from this area, Kasauli, Savatu, as well as from Ladakh. So it's important that you find a place to display what you found. After all, knowledge is for everybody. And once you display something and write it up in a museum like you have built, then it inspires other people to go out and find. So it is a It becomes a chain reaction, and inspiring other people to do something that you have you yourself have experienced and enjoy. That is what it's all about, isn't it?
Thank you. How are you? तो वो जर्नी एक जब मैं पहले आपके पास आया था तो बिल्कुल हम ऐसे पता ही नहीं था जियोलॉजी क्या होती है, फिर आपके साथ आने से
रितेश केम टू मी फॉर डूइंग हिज पीएचडी। फैक्ट हिज पीएचडी वाज इन पैलिंटोलॉजी बट ही वाज interested in everything, especially I think in things where, in subjects where he could help other people, and so he was financing his studies by doing a daily wage work.
You were employed at 82
rupees a day, you know, as a groundwater
hydrogeologist
in the Kasauli area, and that is where he learnt his basic principles, and he expanded them in a very unique manner. He visited most of the Dogra forts round about, and he was always interested in the fact that if you are living in a fort, there has to be water, and if there is water in a fort, how did it come? How did spring water, from what rocks did it come?
So basically the concept was like, if we can get water at the peaks, what was the principle? And if the hydrogeologists of the past, say about 500 years, 600 years ago, without remote sensing, without geophysical methods,
they could find it.
They could find it, why not we? Because we were, what we were doing when we were employed as a geologist, agar 10 bores we were drilling, and if 7 were successful, which we anyway will be successful, and if 3 will go, so it was considered to be 100%. 70% reserve was considered to be 100%. But after analyzing these forts, you know, they had the technology of 100% success rate, because that fort has to survive 24 into...
It has to survive, yes.
So for 24 into 7, you know. So that was the turning point, and when I was able to correlate these basic principles of the investigation, you know, how they were able to get those water at the peaks, that was the turning point. And since then, none of our borewells have failed. None of our borewells have failed.
How old were you when you first tendered for water in the lay monasteries? How old were you?
So I was, that was in 1996-97, after this IBC, when I went to China. So there I met a guy, you know, they were looking, after hearing my lecture, they said, how can you get water, you know? Then after that, we were just sitting for a tea, then that man told that there was some problem of his friend in, they were looking for a project in Leh. That was 1996. So when I told them that, yes, we can do something in Leh, for the Tibetans who migrated after 1959, after Chinese aggression, you know. So that was the time, you know. And I think I was around 26.
Yeah, so at the age of 26 or 27, you took a huge risk.
Yeah. That was not a risk actually at that time. You may remember, we were presented that paper was about zonation of entire Himalayas into 7 hydrostratigraphic zones. Mm-hmm. 6 were in Himachal Pradesh, from Chandigarh to Lahul Spiti area. And the 7th zone was in the Sankosucho zone. So the 7th zone, I was wondering whether I'll ever get an opportunity working as a geologist in Himachal Pradesh. So that was my, you know, sort of a dream that 7th zone, I had to experiment. And then in the Sankosucho zone, nobody had ever drilled groundwater except on the banks of Indus.
Yeah, but for a 27-year-old who has not had formal training, after all you had practical training, but never formal training, that's a very big thing. And then you tendered.
Yeah.
And you got the tender. And then you were able to take your rigs under very adverse conditions.
Yeah, the first year it was difficult.
Yeah. So that I think is remarkable. Because that's not... you need an exceptional person to take that kind of step. You know, because the uncertainty factor is huge.
Was very huge. Because when I initially...
People are very cautious actually.
They said that, you are, okay, even if you are... Because they have British geologists. The company, the NGO was Water Aid, that was run by Queen of England. They were funding this Dalai Lama's project. So when... what happened was, they were very apprehensive because none of them, the geologists or the engineers there, they advocated groundwater. They said, no, you have to get water from Indus. So when I submitted this report that in each and every camp, I can give you 24 into 7 water, so that they said, okay, even if we agree with your report, who's going to execute this project? So the next question was, who's going to execute it, and why should anybody trust the report? Even if anybody can say that there is water. So then this principle of came, no water,
no money.
So that is how I started my company, and that was the basic principle. And that strength I got was from this the experiments which we did with this
the force.
Yeah, that was the strength, you know.
No, but it may seem a very simple thing for you, but very few people start their businesses or start any venture with no output, no money.
But I wanted to do that way.
No, no, I know, I know. I know the rest, of course, is history.
There were about 3,800 Tibetans, you know. And in 24/7, water was provided to them for the first time in the history in the high altitude cold mountain deserts. And then the army, the air force, they never left me, you know, when China pressure.
No,
came.
Basically, after your successes in the monastery, people throng because the groundwater is pure.
Yeah.
You don't require
any treatment.
Plus, it's much warmer than the ambient temperatures.
Yeah.
What more do you want?
It never freezes in winters.
It never freezes.
And no silting problem in summers. That was the typical problem which was faced by the people and the army in general.
So it is actually a paradigm shift from previous efforts.
Yeah, definitely.
And whenever you do something which is radically different, you know, people are very apprehensive. But you were able to not only do that work for the monasteries, but also for the army in all kinds of very adverse conditions. And you're still doing it.
Yeah.
So now 20, 30 years.
And the best part is not even single, people are talking about groundwater depletion, you know. Not even single borewell drilled by us. One centimeter water level has come down. So we have been monitoring these wells, you know. Not all the wells, but few wells we have monitoring, and we are seeing that the perfect results, you know. 20 साल पहले भी जो borewells किए थे, आज भी किए हैं, perfect. नहीं तो normal जो groundwater, central groundwater करती हैं, 10-12 साल में उनके borewell collapse कर जाते हैं. क्योंकि वो उनकी perforations, ये वो technique, हमने बिल्कुल simple अच्छा रखा है. It's, we just thought that, like in one of the seminars in World Water Conference in Stockholm, you know, I was giving a lecture, then they were just apprehensive, कि how? So it's okay, water is blood of Mother Earth. We need proper doctors to operate on it. It is not like just go on drilling or just stop drilling or just create panic about it. It's like, if I have to take a blood from my body, we don't have to go more or less. It is just like, we are just talking and just take the blood and take that much. Don't overexploit it. If we do it in a systematic way, so water is plenty. So whenever we design, we keep this thing in mind. If we are getting, say, about 10 years, we just tell them that it is 5 years, half the water. So that the design of the pump is minimized, you know. Even if he tries to overexploit it, he gets half of it. So that's how we have been doing it from Siachen, minus 30 degrees temperature, to Chushul. It was fun, you know, doing it. Because every day, it was a new challenge and it was a new beginning, you know.
So, of course, it's not finished. The story is not finished.
The story is not finished now. Now we want to...
So, it's always great to have...
You have been a great inspiration, sir.
People who have...
Now, at this age also, you are like a student only, you know. You just want to fight for this papers, research. Every time you are giving us energy, you know.
I enjoy it like you enjoy what you are doing. I enjoy what I am doing.
अच्छा हो गया।
चला जाए यार।
चला जाए सर, बहुत अच्छा है।
बंद कर लो।